Hello everybody, my name is JVFinch1, welcome back to Let's Play Sonic the Hedgehog. Holy crap, that was a really quick transition. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have to even use a level select code to keep doing this, because I don't know if I have the drive to do this all in one day. I really don't. But this is Marble Zone. I hear a lot of people profess hate for Marble Zone, but I kinda like Marble Zone. I'm not entirely sure why either, because this stage is really, really platform heavy, and it's slow paced, and it's hard, and it's just, I can see why people don't like it. But for whatever reason, I always liked Marble Zone. Shit! Okay, well maybe that's a reason why. Is the lava? Lava, fire, and brimstone! It's okay. If you know what you're doing, you can get well over 100 rings in Marble Zone. My goal for most of the first six zones, as in Green Hill Zone Act 1 through Marble Zone Act 3, is to get 100 rings at least per act, so that I can build up some of them extra lives. I'm already up to 6, and I would have 7 or 8 if I hadn't fallen off the platform of sadness in flackin' Green Hill Zone. Actually, this place is very puzzle-oriented, too. I'm starting to notice that. In case you haven't noticed, I like to take my time in my 2D Sonic games, because even when I play Generations, I always love looking around for secrets. The only classic Sonic game that actually I haven't bought, well, I say classic Sonic, but the only 2D Sonic game, rather, that I haven't really bothered to look around for stuff in has been Sonic 4. And I guess Sonic Advanced, from what I've played of those. I never really looked around in those games. I always blew straight through the levels. Which is kind of bad, because Advanced 3 special stages require that you look for those hidden chow, but I didn't bother with that because it was a pain in the ass. And no, I didn't use a walkthrough. So, God! The Lord! Almighty! Plus, Bowser's Castle's fireballs are here. So, fireballs! Fireballs. So, I'm not quite sure what the point. Am I done? Get bonus points all day long! Wow, I only ended up with. Hold on. Ow. It hurts. I only ended up with 35 rings. Huh. Trust me though, Marble Zone is not gonna. from the second part of the Insane Finch Generations Let's Play, when we finished Chemical Plant. Oh. Oh geez, are they all that short? No. No, they're not. Wait a second. What's that bat just doing there? Just like, eh. He's cold. I mean, I know why he's there, but he just looks so funny. They're such cannon fodder, too. I mean, you can just go up and just brrrr, and they're gone, and they're gone. These are the parts that I always hear people cite whenever they talk about Marble Zone. Is like, remember when you had to just wait for those things to go across the lava? Didn't that suck? And I was like, I don't know. The only reason I didn't like them at first was because Sonic Genesis made it very, very difficult to platform. And I just love how the sprite clipping there makes the lava just. Okay. Aw, you broke me. You threw off my groove! But I. You know, even from an aesthetic touch point. Touch point? Okay. Even from an aesthetic touch, I always liked Marble Zone. The lava and, like, the purple. I don't know, it was calming but frustrating at the same time. I always liked it. Marble Zone was always like that mysterious place. Marble Zone had a really weird development period too. Like, I believe that Marble Zone was originally going to have UFOs in the background. And I cannot remember what zone it was in this game. I'm trying to think. It's a toss-up between this Spring Yard and Starlight, but one of those zones was going to be called Sparkling Zone. I have a feeling it was going to be Starlight Zone. But one of them was going to be called Starlight Zone. Not Starlight, Sparkling. And this one was going to have UFOs in the background. I have no idea why they took that out, because that would have been amazing. I mean, hell, the. I don't know why I'm bringing this up, but the Comet Cannon already has loads of aliens, so. Where, Batman? I'm gonna stand in shame now. I mean, it was like, it was right there, and I could have avoided it. But that's not how you do things here. Because if that was how I did things, then, well, This would go a lot easier, and I don't make things easy on myself. Holy balls, I almost hit that Caterkiller. Oh yeah, I know the names of lots of badniks. Caterkiller, Buzz Bomber, Crabmeat, Chomper. Pork. Is that his name? Porker? The bomb pig? Oh no! Well, both of you suck. Damn it! It did not go how I wanted it to. I wanted them 10,000 points. That's not actually 10,000 points.
Yeah.
And now, see, it's just little things like these that I love about, like, Sonic 1. It's just you can do stuff like, you can just do shit like this. Just like, I'm on the lava. Plus, it's the only time you can destroy the Caterkiller by touching something other than their bodies. For instance, and then they bounce around and it's funny. Why aren't you laughing? Oh my god. I have 93 rings right now, and I would really... Oh, it's the end of the level! Damn it. And I've just decided I'm just gonna go for the special stages. If I don't get all the Chaos Emeralds, well, then that sucks. I wanted to do them, but my button is freaking out on me. I don't like it! Shit. Oh. No, it was good. It went well. Oh my god. You expected skill from me playing a classic game of any kind? Like, actually. Oh no. I was gonna say, this might be like the first 16-bit game I've ever Let's Played, but no, that Link to the Past holds that beauty. I love Link to the Past. That still remains to this day my favorite Let's Play that I've done. I don't know if it's gonna keep that title or not, though. Because Project Radianta might actually steal that title. Project Radianta, just to give you guys a little wet tease, is also... Wet tease? That was... Okay. I meant to say wet your appetite, but... Look, a chicken! Look, a blue hedgehog! But Project Radianta is also a 16-bit game, and it is also for the Genesis, so this is very fitting that this happens. That this Let's Play is going on. I'm doing lots of Genesis stuff. It's so much fun. The other one's for the Wii. Like, literally every other console game that I play is either for the Wii or the GameCube, because the PlayStation 2 controller I have that I'm using right now, the shoulder button does not work. So I can't, like, do Kingdom Hearts or anything. Mr. Insanity has to bring over his controller whenever we do Kingdom Hearts. If you're wondering how I broke this controller, actually, it was during Final Fantasy X when I was fighting the big dragon creature outside St. Bavel. That's the name of that city in the sky, right? I think so. It's been so long since I've even touched that game. Which is sad, because I want to finish it, because it's a damn good game. I've been playing 13 in terms of Final Fantasy. Which is not that bad, actually. I quite like 13. Shoot you! But enough about Final Fantasy XIII, back to Sonic. I'm trying to think of any other kinds of trivia that I might have for Marble Zone, but really, that UFO bit is the only other thing I can think of. And in terms of, just Sonic in general, if you want to know the original plot to this game, and I don't know why I link this in my mind with ship. No. I guess I'm not using the shield then. Whew. But I don't know why I link this to Marble Zone. It's probably just because it's the zone that I was playing whenever I heard this for the first time. The original plot to this game was that Eggman Robotnik, I'm sorry, was gonna... God lord. Robotnik was actually going to kidnap Sonic's blonde girlfriend, Madonna. Who was like this thin stick woman in a... God! Honestly, losing rings is one of the worst possible sounds in the universe. I hate it. Oh, I'm up shit creek without a paddle, aren't I? I mean, there's rings right there that I'm gonna get, and then I'm just gonna... Caterkiller! Caterkiller, dinner was ready an hour ago! Where are you? I think I missed a secret area. Oh, balls, I wanted to... It's all these things that you think of when you're like... Oh, when you're like in school and you should be paying attention to something else, and you're like, boy, howdy, I really want to do this in my Let's Play of Sonic the Hedgehog, only like the 8 millionth one on the YouTubes. But... Fuck, I think I missed it. Act 3 is like the most strenuous thing ever. Marble Zone Act 3. Only thing worse is Labyrinth Zone Act 3 and Scrap Brain Zone Act 3. Don't talk to me about Scrap Brain Zone Act 3, also known as Labyrinth Zone Act 4. Something something zone act something something zone mark something. I could just say zone and act like 8 million times in this Let's Play and I would still say something productive. Yep, I missed that secret area. There's a secret area where you can go through the wall after a lava section and you'll get lots of fancy prizes for your belly, but I missed it. I do not practice for these Let's Plays. There's also a phone, and this boss can be a bit of a bitch. I don't like this boss. This boss always used to give me such strains when I played it in Genesis, so I never got past Marble Zone. Like, I got to Spring Yard and I was like, what is this place? Ma'am, I couldn't tell you if I wanted to, but trust me, I got somewhere new. It's so magical. Bonk. Ah. But yes, overall, Marble Zone is actually quite fun. You heard something crash upstairs, I'm sure. That does it for this part of Let's Play Sonic the Hedgehog. Join me next time where we take on Spring Yard Zone.